Idaho right there, does it, boys?
It does not. There's a ton of skiing potential back here, like a lot more than...
We found ourselves in a time of constant change. With uncertain restrictions and the future unknown, the standard idea of travel had been rewritten.
This is right on the edge of my ability. You can stop here. You know, unless you're gonna listen, you just stay.
We're totally committed now.
Oh my god,
that looks amazing.
And we can drop that cornice into it. Holy.
The classic locations and usual tale of following the snow no longer was an option. Realizing that some of our finest gems had been right beneath our noses, we set forth on a journey into our own backyards. The quest to find something new within the familiar.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
This is the story of a group of friends rediscovering the landscapes that shaped who they are today. It's only natural to begin the story at the place we know best. Thousands of hours throughout childhood were spent skiing these same designated slopes. From Bashing Gates to Burning Pow, I know this mountain like the back of my hand. Yet every time, every turn is always different. The buzz of an impending storm can be felt throughout the community. It began with skipping school in the adolescent years and has evolved into chasing beyond the ski area boundaries. The apprehension surrounding these cycles has never changed, always fueled by the desire to find untracked snow. On these missions over the years, I've always wondered what's just around the next corner. This was finally the time to find out.
See where you coming from, but I know just what you running for.
familiarity of the home hill and the surrounding woods was more than enough to keep us occupied over the years. Yet just a short distance away, a row of giants loomed amongst the horizon. These mountains had been a staple of the skyline throughout my childhood, yet always remained a mystery. Seldom talked about, and even less frequently explored, the lure of these hills was seemingly impossible. It was a place that became a monolith in my subconscious, always looming in the back of the mind. The time was now. With little data and lots of ambition, we ventured into the belly of the beast.
Man, the craziest part about these mountains is like, they're just so unsuspecting from the foothills, and then you just get into them and it's just like, wow. Man, those chokes are tight on elephants. There's some natural avalanche activity over there.
Step by step, the rhythmic pattern slowly put a dent into the distance between us. A calming factor allowing the mind to drift once again. Back to a place it's been so many times before. The idle mind feasts on these memories, an instinct preparing you for the moment. It was as if I'd been there a million times before, like seeing a face you can't help but recognize.
Okay. No fall zone. I'm just worried these are trigger points because it's a little bit shallower. Okay, we gotta be precise with our movements through all this. Be really careful. We're totally committed now. Oh my god.
What are you doing, Essex? I got this, you got this. If you just stay, you can stop here. This is right on the edge of my ability.
Oh my god. You don't do that every day. Oh my god.
That was scary.
Essex is dropping in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Up on
my. Yeah, baby!
Wow, that was sick. And just like that, it's over. As we depart the mountains, a bittersweet feeling of accomplishment blends with the awe that this winter was really only the beginning. Truly a lifetime worth of photos waiting to be explored. The backyard is endless. As the seasons change, tales of the winter endeavors slowly creep their way into conversation. Stories of other peaks catch your attention, and you find yourself reveling in the excitement of others. Yet as soon as the tunnel vision subsides, it's easy to see there's been many people before, and destined to be many after, that have blazed the trail and shared these experiences.
It was crazy to think that it was 20 years ago this year that we did this for the first time.
As the snow melts and the flowers bloom, there's always time for one last outing, a chance to gather and celebrate, a tradition of sorts.
This year was going to be the 20th anniversary of the first time that they did the pond skim, and they invited us up to kind of reinvent the event.
We Rochambeau'd 20 years ago to do this, and I won, meaning I didn't have to go first. So Josh, this morning we were talking, he's like, technically, it's your turn. So I said, fair enough.
You're only 44 once.
The period at the end of the sentence, and finally, the only way to close the book and set aside the story until the snow flies once again.
Oh. Oh. Oh my god! Did I actually just do that?
How's the pit looking?
They don't listen to me much.
Oh! That's it! It moved enough, dude, for sure. Even by Jeopardy rules.
The drone has landed, my dude.
That is a wrap. 2K21. Famous potatoes, baby. Oh! Yeah!